Hey everyone, Diogo Marques here, your friend in sales. Today I want to share with you this book. It is called The Psychology of Sales Call Reluctance, and it was written by George Dudley and Shannon Goodson. These are two psychologists, and they decided to see what was happening when people were doing calls, or salespeople. They started seeing some common patterns, and from their point of view, they needed to address it, and they did in the study. They published their findings in the study. Essentially, it all comes down to how you were brought up, and there are certain triggers that cause you to start acting a certain way. And all of us, we have this inherent and erroneous sense of how other people perceive us and how we perceive ourselves. It's a constant path of improvement. You are improving to become a better person. So you need to face essentially the the bar, right? Because you're trying to get more weight done, right? So you are like facing some inner demons, and all these are triggered when you are doing this sales call. And I won't get into all the details because this is a kind of a mouthful, but it's important for you to get this book. I highly recommend you to get it, because all of us as entrepreneurs, essentially, we are trying to figure things out, right? We are problem solvers. That's the whole overall arching concept. So essentially, you need to leverage what these people have found in order to help you move forward. You will find that some personality traits that you have, you are facing some inner demons when you are making that call. You're expecting someone that essentially is not real, right? If you have been seeing this series that I've been recording, I just address this in this way. This is my own way of seeing things and makes it easier when I'm doing my job. Essentially, just telling myself it's not real. It's just talking to the human person, right? And if you think about it, I actually had this happen quite a lot, actually. It's like if you tell yourself you're going to call a billionaire right now, right? You immediately get like in a stressed state, right? But if you were calling like someone that you've already been talking to like for the last 10 years, like just fine, right? So why would it be different, right? Essentially, you are providing a service. You're not selling anything, right? You keep the sale essentially is a exchange from someone that needs something, right? And they will pay you for what you provided, right? That's what's called a sale. But you're not selling anything yet, right? You just talking to that person and see if the goods fit or not, if it's a good fit or not. And I find it a little bit bizarre because you get into this emotional state that essentially is not real. It's like a fight or flight thing. And when you get to the root cause of the issue, you'll find that essentially you are the one keeping you from moving forward, which is kind of ridiculous because you want to move forward, right? So it's the lizard brain thingy telling you, like from data, from prehistorical data, telling you that you're going to die or anything. You're not going to die, dude. You're just making a phone call, right? So you need to get out of your own way. All of us need to get out of our own way sometimes and start seeing things for what they are. It's just making a phone call, right? Now, something happens to our brains, and this is why I mean by you need to read the book in order to get to the root cause of your own specific issue. And I'll give you an example from just a call that I made just a couple of minutes ago. Today I'm a bit exhausted and I'm losing my voice a bit. And the last call before the last call, the guy was kind of rude. But since I'm trained, I know how to deal with people and already am expecting a certain model, and then I apply it when I'm calling those people. Let's say you're talking to someone, right? And then you have this kind of radar, right? Seeing patterns so that you can apply like the model that you have in order to deal with that specific type of individual, right? So I have this model that when I start seeing that there are signs of that person, it's kind of a dysfunctional MF, right? And they are trying to like hook in a bad way to get more dysfunctional in their way so that they can deploy all that stuff, right? I kill the call immediately, right? Because I already have those pre-made responses that we have been covering in this playlist, so that you can kill the call effectively, because you need to keep your energy. So this was the call before the last one. Now, this is what I wanted to share with you. Obviously, because I'm tired today, right? When I made that call, I even got worse because I'm kind of like exhausted today. But then, this is what I mean by psychological states and why this book is so important, is that I got the psychotherapist on the phone. And this is something that I don't know what these people do. I honestly don't do. I think there's their own power. That's why they choose that career as their main way of basically dealing with people. Because it's a superpower. They recharge you. And it is something that I can't let go of that. Because I called that lady, right? And she was a psychotherapist, right? And she was like asking me stuff about the product and all that. I feel good. It's I don't know what that is, but I just feel better. And it gets me, like, I remember when I was selling door-to-door, it was the exact same thing. I knew there are some type of individual, some type of personalities that they did something to me. I don't know what that is. I just know that I just felt better. And actually, a little bit in awe, to be honest, because in one of the insurance companies that I work with, the guys like that. Like, I actually met them once, because we've been doing the whole thing by phone now because of due to the COVID crap. It's like, I feel better when I talk with them. I don't know what that is, right? It's just, it's some sort of therapeutical thing he has, right? It's like some sort of, and pretty much like they have this mix of people there. I find it pretty intriguing. They have like more aggressive people, like people are in the field, right? Knocking on doors and making phone calls and getting raspy voices and getting nose and saying, go fuck yourself. You don't have a problem, right? Because that's the way that you deal with. But then you have these people, right? They recharge you. That's their overall thing. And I think they need you, to be honest. I didn't used to think about it like this, but I think they need you. I think they need this connection to the world. It doesn't matter if it's a man or a woman. It's just they have this attraction towards more aggressive people. I think they lack that part in their life than their lives. And I think they get recharged themselves as well when they deal with you, right? So maybe it was in their upbringings, they started seeing that maybe their dad or something was like very aggressive, right? And they were the connector because they saw, he saw, he or she, doesn't matter, saw this situation between the mom and pops, right? And he started recharging that, so he started feeling better, so he got calmer, right? This is my theory about the thing. I'm not a psychotherapist, but I've been seeing this model over and over again. So when you deal with these people, because they made it like their life mission to become the recharger, right? It doesn't matter if it's a man or a woman. It really doesn't matter. It has nothing to do with sexual thing at all. It's the way they talk to you, the way they never use words like to, they just put you down or anything like that. It's the other way around, exactly. It's like to lift you up. So even if it's someone that you're doing a cold call, and one funny thing is, when I cold calling, it's always the same thing. It's always the same pattern. I do my first snippet, like we have been talking about. I do my first snippet, and there's this enormous pause. And obviously, there are several types of people, but when we deal with psychotherapists like this lady that I just talked to, she gets in her psychotherapist mode, right? Because she knows she's dealing with that specific type, right? The telemarketing type, the more aggressive type, right? They know how to handle people, right? So they get you like at ease, right? You're not stressed anymore. They pick up the conversation and start talking, right? And what I want to share with you, and the takeaway from this, besides the book, this is what I wanted to share with you, is that you need to figure out yourself better. Obviously, all of us are trying to figure ourselves better, but this is really important, especially when you're doing telemarketing, because you're going to face many demons, and most of them are not true. And when you start doing calls on a consistent basis and seeing exactly how you're feeling, like what's happening to you, get a bunch of mirrors, start seeing yourself, like, because if you like have monitors with stuff all over the place, you don't see that, you start getting tense. So get a mirror. When you're talking to yourself, he just happens to call Steven, and the other one is Sandra, and the other one is Raquel, and the other one is, doesn't matter, right? So but you're seeing yourself, right? And if you start noticing like arched back, or like you're getting like a little tense, like relax, like speak calmly, keep talking to themselves like you're talking to yourself as well, like calm, no, nobody's bothering you here, right? And obviously you have that radar going on. As soon as you spot signs of dysfunctional motherfuckers, kill the conversation. That's it, end of story. Move on to the next one, keep your energy. And obviously if you find people that are more psychotherapists, that you'll feel that when you're having the conversation. Like, take advantage of that in a good way. I mean it. Like, obviously, trying to help people, right? You're selling your product, but selling, you're doing the exchange. But just take advantage of that because they like it. That's their, they like doing that. It's kind of their gift to you, right? So they have this need to use their energy to kind of to recharge you. So that's, don't think it's like, oh, I'm taking advantage of that person. It's not like that at all. They like it. They really like it. That's their overall thing. I think I've met people that they started, you won't believe this, but this is actually true, that they cry like when they are alone if they failed recharging someone in their lives in throughout their day. They are very, these types of individuals, they're very peculiar, they're very special, because your overall thing is like they need to recharge dad so that he can calm down and then speak better with mom, right? So everyone is like in equilibrium. So these people, as psychotherapists, they have this mission, like every situation that they encounter, the thing needs to be like okay with everyone. So you, as a telemarketer or a door-to-door salesperson, my peers, if you go there and like let yourself get filled up with that energy, because it will you'll feel better. And this is the advice that I got for you. So if you are struggling with call reluctance, use some of my tips that I've been sharing with you. Get this book. It's a really important book, because as far as I know, to be honest, actually it's the only book that I found that is addressing the topic specifically. Just, it's no bullshit. These are two psychologists. They are professionals in the specific field, and they found out a couple of things. And a last one I'd like to share with you, actually, this is kind of a bonus, is, and Jordan Belfort from, you know, The Wolf of Wall Street, he talks a lot about this, and this does work. This does work. It's really, really powerful. It's about you having this memory. All of us, we are different, but it's you triggering a certain memory from a certain event that you have had in the past that gets you in that state that you feel better. And I don't mean like that Tony Robbins crap that you feel all hyped up and stuff. No, it's like, let's say last time you got $100,000 in your bank account, like when you got the deposit, right? You felt, you know what I mean? So it's like there's this feeling, right? Or let's say you got this pretty girl, went there and you started talking and you had a good conversation, because you were expecting a rejection, and the other thing, the other way around happened. Actually, she accepted you, right? Or any sort of event that the thing worked out for you, right? This is what I want to encourage for you, is like you need to retrigger that memory every time that you are doing something. All this, and this is what I want to share with you to complete this video, is that all these, the books and the tips that I have for you, it's not a one-time thing. It's like a little bit of these all. It's like it will help you, lift you up. So you have to like organize your mind in order to kind of all these like on-off switches, right? You need to like on the whole thing, right? So that you, because each one has a different triggers a different situation in your body. So when you have all these ones working, like I said, there's no perfect solution for this, but it's really, really, really helpful. And this is what I have for you guys today. So I hope you enjoy this video. Remember to subscribe, and if you have any further questions, let me know, and I'll be more than happy to jump on board and help you guys out. Peace.